Whoa. Nobody wants to eat meat that died of natural causes.
Yeah.
It tastes much better if you kill it.
I'm not denying that.
I wasn't always trying to claim.
This is true of the farm, I know that. If something dies on its own on our farm, they get paid.
And it's funny, some people buy it, too. I was like Jeff Berwick, who's usually not a complete jackass, and he's a complete jackass.
Oh, yeah, the,
He's usually high, rather than that.
Well, I mean, he counted a bunch of people out of money or stuff.
Yeah.
I don't think he was buying it, huh?
Well, he did.
I think he wanted to do something.
It's funny that he's got a nice, rich life, and all these other people got ripped off.
Yeah, that's what's... That's
a little suspect
to me.
He's easily bought off.
I feel like from there, the entire video is just going to be like the back of my head.
Oh, that's okay.
Jeff Irwin? If you're a scared shithead, you're going to plead guilty because they're going to get you a federal firearm charge. Committing a felony while in possession of a firearm.
They're going to have to be lucky to get me alive.
Cynthia Nixon.
They came through once, they searched him once.
Cynthia Nixon, really?
Considered to run for governor of New York.
Cynthia Nixon running for governor of New York. Wow.
I like your video. You heard it here first, people.
I want to Abram.
Yes.
Actually, one of my bars.
Yes. Vice
you
News.
Pigs, chickens, Abram. You know, it's pretty. I need an old one.
Oh, speaking of which, did you hear about Vice News? Covering Charlottesville. They did, and Chris Cantwell was in the video from what I heard.
Sergeant Bailey, he was one of the heads.
He's toast, man. YouTube closed down his account, so did PayPal, so did.
He got banned from a dating site.
He got from OK Cupid.
Kalkaska, Cadillac, he roamed the whole area. Those were the only places. Nobody north of the river tried to.
This one guy, he used to be like. Oh no. Oh,
because they're quoting
video.
The five patients.
I said, I'll tell you when I'm not on video. It's very,
there's other parts of the marijuana act that show that the five patient rule is kind of infectious. There's a part in the section.
Still, there's some suspense for anyone watching it. I wish I.
Oh. Okay. That's where we get north from. I'm from Hale.
Warren, enough north, aren't anywhere central.
I'll come back.
The
bag right here.
Yeah. That's a technicality. It's my language, but I don't have anything else wrong in the show because we already have an existing organization. The last time that I wrote language, and I was part of that show.
And they're from Europe.
He's from Midland, Michigan, so I'm in the city.
Michigan was not known for wanting to be the first one to do it.
Okay, so I know I'm missing food so far, and a couple beers here and there. Who else is missing food?
A Diet Pepsi with
Brian. Yeah, I'll get that right now, sir.
Okay.
Anyone missing food? Anything I need to fill the kitchen?
You can get one of these.
The bread?
Yeah,
we'll be right out. Thank you.
Can you pay for that?
I forget what they call this. I think it's like a cabbage roll. It's like a platter.
It's a cabbage. It just disappeared. I thought it was some kind of seafood.
I was trying to think what they stuff.
That's the biggest cabbage roll I've ever seen.
Well, that bothers me. I'm not sure.
Can I get a
bag? Yep, I'm going to bring a whole bunch. Cool. Okay, now we all got our food. Call of order.
A buffet.
Not just a buffet. Matt, you got the roll call going?
Yeah, I already got it.
All right, got to add a couple.
Oh,
all right.
Hello.
Hello.
Every
Hey, has everybody looked at the agenda? Who cares to look at the agenda?
Nope.
Not the best one of the time.
Can I have a copy of the agenda, please?
I think we ran out of copies some time ago.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah, I am the evil, it's great, how are you?
Oh, living the dream.
Is there a motion to approve the agenda?
Motion to approve the agenda?
Second.
All there.
Aye.
Aye.
Is there anyone who needs to see the minutes, see the minutes?
Motion to approve the minutes?
Motion to approve.
All there.
Aye.
Probably going to open floor. I'd like to make a motion to dedicate the entirety of our open floor to our guests.
Everyone, we're going to field farm?
Those in favor?
Aye.
Would you like to finish chewing and take as much time as you need?
Now I'm going to brush your teeth. Hi. I'm Dana Carter. Who here is not familiar with Abrogator? Are there people that aren't familiar with it? All right, I will explain the whole thing. If anyone would like to actually see the wording, it's right here. I can read it to you.
Can you guys pass it down?
Just take one and pass it down. So essentially, it is language to completely take away everything that they've done since 1937. It is hopefully going to end the problem. It calls
for roads. 1937, they're getting rid of roads.
Oh damn! I wish I meant on the cannabis plant. Oh. I should have been on the roads.
They're jump right into it.
They're getting rid of my property.
Sweet.
We're going back to
Groveland,
right? It's gonna be way better. All right.
They would be a problem if they just let us do the bikes and stuff that Russia's making.
Anyways, let's focus.
Okay, so what this will do is add to the Constitution of Michigan an extra article in Section 1 that would, like I said, make the cannabis plant lawful. It would take away any way that we can think of that they could put anyone in a cage or take away any rights of an individual. We've also added in retroactive. That will be one of the biggest things.
All right, sir, I have one up there for you. So, I held off on the other beer. Let me know if you still have it. All right. This is for you. Coffee, beer.
But that's one of the things that challenges on. What retroactive will do, you see it in all of their laws. It takes whatever law they've made that's bad for us and gets anybody who's possibly going to be in trouble for it now. And sometimes they do it in our favor, but not very often. But they put that in a lot of laws. And so we put it in there to get anyone who's in a cage out. There are plenty of people still in cages in Michigan. People off the paper, like I said, anyone who has probation papers, anyone who's got a past record will be removed from the retroactivity. It is pretty important. Arrests have gone up 17% in Michigan since the enactment of the Medical Marijuana Act. And the people that are going to jail have the permission slip from the state.
Who's arresting them?
Usually the state police, for the most part. That's what we've learned. It's the state police and the task forces.
SWAT teams all.
The counties don't really get involved much unless they're part of one of the task forces, one or two of their officers. That's the only way.
So you say arrest them, but I'm more curious what about have more people to put in jail.
You said what?
People said that more arrests have happened because of the Michigan.
Or since, not
so. So what I'm asking is. But is that result any difference? Has there been more people put in jail? Thank you.
Yes. Okay. More people have been put in jail, more people have been put on probation. All over the state. Because the Medical Marijuana Act was a statutory legislation when it was enacted by the people. Lansing can do whatever they want with it as long as they have a 3/4 majority. So they changed it fundamentally. They changed it. Two times in 2010, five times in 2013, then they changed it again just last December. So they keep changing it, so nobody knows. They even, they violated Michigan Constitution Article 4, Section 25 by creating a law that says you have to have it in your trunk because it's dangerous for it to be anywhere else. And then, because it's maintained, the cops have decided that that box needs to have a lock on it even though the law doesn't say that. And therefore, it's just going to keep them going to jail for that. And they have their permission slip from the state. And yeah, there's tons of Supreme Court case law on it and tons of stuff on it. And you can see where they have done this over and over and over. Their latest act is shutting down pretty much all of the dispensaries. That's their newest, latest plan. They had a meeting on it yesterday. They're not going to at this time. We still aren't sure what they're going to do. Most of them realize they didn't have the power, but we don't know what they will do. They have essentially closed down every dispensary in northern Michigan. They are all gone. There are no more dispensaries in northern Michigan because they've decided that it's unlawful. And that is where I see most of the dispensaries going down and be under some sort of a police issue. The ones that are left. There'll be cease and desist from Schuette, and then the police will come in and raid them, just like it has up north. Gaylord's standing strong, though. Those guys, they need your props. This is the third time many of them have reopened, and they're trying. They're trying to live as obedience. The problem is half of them still continue to plead guilty once they have charges, which doesn't help the situation at all. So, yeah. So that's one of the biggest things, and our goal is just to get Lansing and everyone out of this. It's our bodies, it's our right to consume whatever we want into them, it's our right to grow plants. This is pretty much the only plant that I cannot grow on my farm without either permission from my government, which I might still get raided, or going to jail anyway. So it just needs to be ended, completely ended. And making it a constitutional amendment requires Lansing, like, let's say they want to change it. They have to put it back on the ballot. They can have all the majority they want, but they still have to let the people in Michigan vote on it. This gives them no taxes. I mean, they'll still get their pound of flesh. They'll get it in payroll, sales taxes to register for anything that's a prepared food, or if somebody decides to make a hemp factory and create growth, they're going to get money there. They'll get the property tax. They'll still get it. But they won't get that 10% excise tax that the other group is begging for. No, it's 10. So it'll be 10 plus your 6%. I don't want to talk too badly about them, but it's 10 plus your 6% at the register, because the state of Michigan will get their 6% at the register, period. They're already doing that through the new law that's being created. They're charging medical marijuana patients 3% tax for their cannabis if they get it at a dispensary once the MMFLA becomes law. So they're already doing it. And they'll get 16% once it's out the door under the recreational plan that's in play from the other end. This takes away all fines, all fees, any regulations. They can't do anything to put anyone in a cage from the way we feel that we've written this. Another thing that I love greatly, that they're hinting that if we get on the ballot, they'll challenge me on this one. No agency of the state shall receive monies from the federal government or any other entity to be used in the promotion of continued prohibitions on cannabis. We all know about that law that they just gave us a new extension on with the shutdown, where they're not supposed to attack medical marijuana states, but they are. They're doing it every day. Because they still get those grants from the Burns Justice Award. They don't say cannabis on them, but that's what they're using them for. I-75 right now, from I-75 to the bridge is an area of, or from Gaylord to the bridge, is an area of trafficking of marijuana. So they get a $2.7 million grant a year to pull everybody over and ask if they have a marijuana card or cannabis in their car. So that's
probably a good deal for
one
you.
Of the things we're dealing with. The money that people are paying for their cards is being used to enforce the arbitrary rules they're making up as they go along with the Medical Marijuana Act. Any of the money that your courts are getting for their SAPA programs for the kids that might use it, any of the money they're getting for their drug testing. Every time somebody gets drug tested because they've been busted for this plant, we the people are paying $7 of their drug testing so that they can have a discount. every county. You're doing it right here in McComb. You are. The biggest thing for me is just be done with it. And now we have to get 315,748, I believe is the number, within 180 days. If we do not get what we started on September 1st done by a certain date, we can continue on until July 6th of next year before we have, that's our hard deadline. So like, let's say, September seems to be going really good so far. But if by chance we have to throw those away, people will still have those signatures. They will still seek those people out if it's in needed. We have quite a few people doing this. It's very grassroots. We have people printing out their own petitions at this moment, and people are printing them off by the tens of thousands.
You 315,000 by what?
Huh?
By what?
Our hard deadline that it has to be completed by is July 6th of 2018.
Okay.
We have to be doing it. How many days?
Complete 180-day window. So whatever day one signature is, the day last signature is, needs to be technically 179 days if you want to get technical, but yeah, they call it 180.
Okay.
So that's that part. So that's, it's kind of hard. We can always use all the help we can get. We need people to volunteer to get signatures. It's not very hard, and it's actually kind of fun. You get to educate people at the same time. Most people will stand in line. I'm up in northern Michigan at the frozen potato festival. People were in line to sign this. So it's that big. They just want it done. Most people don't want people engaged. They don't want taxation on it. They just want it done. We, you know, they use money. We have lots of things going on. We have a website. It's abergang.org. And that'll show you where you can volunteer, because we really like most people to register so that we know you're passing them out so we can get back with you. To get them back. Also, it's a really great way to go and put where things are. It's like if you get a hub, like a dispensary or a smoke shop that'll put it out for you, you can go there and see where we've put things in different cities and stuff, who has them, where to find them. And I'm not good at it. None of my stuff's on the forum because I suck with the computer, but my heart's there. Somebody created it for us, so that's good. It's just, I'm really excited about it this time. People who were so against us last time are now for us. People who were completely saying we were complete idiots are now for us. Pretty much the only ones not for us at this moment are the lawyers and the people that benefit from the recreational legislation. If you go to all the forums and websites on, or all the things on Facebook, you can see the only ones arguing with us anymore nowadays are those people, Powers and Irwin and, you know, why? The ones that stand much to gain from it. Next week, I believe it's in Grand Rapids, the Cannabis Lawyers Association is having a meeting so that you can learn the new Medical Marijuana Facilities Licensing Act law, and they're charging $200,000. Well, when Lansing writes 38 pages of madness,
$200,000.
If you're trying to create a business right now, you have to figure out a way through all the crap. They haven't even finished making the laws and the rules. It took them until 2011 to finish the rules for the Medical Marijuana Act. So it's going to be a great ride. Oh, I know. I just hate people. I mean, it's that nuts. It's that nuts.
Look,
Kevin.
Close to a third of a million signatures in order to get eligible, put it on the ballot in November 2018.
Yes.
You get the touch.
It's
you
not
know,
much.
We might find something else out there that just gives me on every other.
It'll be a statewide ballot initiative. And the front of it, you know, what's on your ballot will be that black card on the top, plus just a little bit from the back. In fact, our entire back might even fit on there. It's that simple. And it does everything we could possibly want to take it out of Lansing. And maybe less of our thefts will be spent on our own jailing.
So, is there a signature total difference between a constitutional amendment and
very small. Theirs was like 280.
The first time?
Well, because the lawyers wrote it.
What happened?
The lawyers wrote it. Guess who helped write it and then became a state legislator not too long after that? Mr. Jeff Burr, the one who spoke at the convention. He's a lawyer.
Yeah,
he's
right.
Architect. Yes.
Okay.
No, but I got to see it on video.
He was the guy who spoke
at the luncheon.
Yeah, well, I don't think we
so the same guy that wrote the Medical Marijuana Act with all his lawyer friends, Matt Abel, Jim Powers, all of those people, have now written the new law that they're trying to pass, the new their ballot initiative, and they need 280,000+. So we need a few more, but not.
Okay, and the reason why you need more is because it's a constitutional.
Constitutional. We will effectively change the Constitution.
If both proposals get on the ballot,
you can vote for both of them.
Well, I understand we can't, but is there any fear that who otherwise would support it would end up voting for neither, not knowing which one's the right one?
No, don't vote for both.
Well, I understand as you tell them.
It's okay.
No, I've never heard anybody say anything like that. Well, I didn't sign up, and I guess I'll sign this one too.
And those people will vote for both. The only people that wouldn't vote for that are people who love taxation. And love cops and love regulation.
I'd never be able to. The war on drugs. They like the war on drugs.
And the really pretty thing about it is if everybody votes for both of them and both of them make the ballot and both of them win, this one cancels out every single thing of that 4 pages of gobbledygook that the other guys are passing around for signature.
This is a constitutional amendment.
Right.
Yes. And not only that, but it tells them that there can be no excise tax, no fines, no fees, no regulations to diminish use. None of that can be done. So, like, by saying no regulation to diminish use, try to come up with one. It says right here in the Constitution, you can't do that. Do they follow the Constitution? Who knows? But now people say, look, it's right here. I was given permission to do whatever I want. My dream is to grow acres of hemp, not even cannabis. But acres and acres of hemp, and then my husband or somebody goes to the little tower in Michigan that's dying now and builds a refinery with oil or something to grow or whatever the heck we're going to make. Oh, what? I just want to grow
this. It's a hell of a lot less harmful than growing soy.
Huh?
It's a hell of a lot less harmful than growing soy.
Oh boy, soy messes with your entire DNA, but that's a different
thing. I was like, soy. Eating soybeans?
Yes. Did you know soy is in it? Well, this is off the subject of candies, but yes, soy messes with your That's why men grow wheat and things they don't get soy. They said we wouldn't even need any money to do anything with if people would just get signatures.
I'll be really fat and lazy.
There's a farm out there.
Here's the question. When you have a little bit of money, why is your house just the United States kind of generator? Two-thirds of the space to appeal it and all kinds of vast super majorities and stuff like that. Why does Michigan have just a simple majority of fastest? It's got to get on the, it's got to have a little bit more signatures.
It's got to have just a little more signatures. And the Medical Marijuana Act passed with 63%. That's what put it in the And that was during a presidential election, so we don't know what's going to happen this time. It'll be gubernatorial, so who knows what
people
don't really shoot. That's how Snyder
Shooty
win. Because I'm telling you, Shooty, pig farmers hate him, the cannabis users hate him, everybody hates him, and somehow he's sitting
that's
in office still.
That's the guy who's the
AJ, So, nobody comes to visit in
office.
He's Shooty still there.
He's got a big sign that we love Bill Shooty on
96,
right?
Yeah, him and some woman on the other side.
Did you have any other questions?
Yeah, I was just wondering, how much would this be, like, in terms of, like, say, per signature, how much money does it cost to get per signature?
Signature gathers are usually paid $1 a signature.
Dollar signature.
But you don't get any.
No, I'm doing this for the love of the game. I'm doing this for my daughter. I'm doing this for my future grandbabies. I'm doing this so nobody I know ever sits in a cage or has arbitrary papers on their shoulders saying they can't do anything.
So when we sign for you, that nobody gets a nod.
Right. Or if you go out on your own, I mean, Ben's getting signatures and he's not getting paid a dollar. There are a couple people throughout the state, this is really fun. Like three or four people now. One's in the thumb, one's down in like Kalamazoo, one over here on the west side. They're offering $1,000 to the first person to show up at their house with 1,000 signatures. So they're paying $1 signature out of their own money, so that's really fun. That's what just people are bringing in upon themselves to do these things. It's just amazing. So, yeah, people are like sending out tens of thousands of petitions. They're ready. They're done.
500,000 signatures should be easy to do. How many?
Well, 500,000 would be great. So you have definitely enough to get rid of any bad signatures. You know? And like if there's a coffee stain on the page, that's a bad signature.
You need at least a third more than they say you need.
That's the number based on that. What's the number based on that?
It's based on the number of votes for the Secretary of State during the last gubernatorial election.
It would have been after 2014.
Joe B. Yeah.
Joe A.
I have to do the math on that one.
Right.
And the thing is, do the people want it? I mean, in the most beautiful world, when you get to every single candidate's card
over, 35,000 people lose money. That's
35,000 signatures. Oh, most of us are potheads. They're doing it.
But most potheads aren't doing it.
No. Most potheads are listening to the lawyers and saying you need to be taxated and regulated.
Any final thoughts?
Just if you would like to help, contact myself or Timothy Locke. Again, our website is www.abrogate.com.
How do you spell abrogate?
Or
right there.
A-B-R-O-G-A-T-E. And we're on Facebook too. We have like two different Facebook groups. And help us get signatures. Talk about us. Tell your friends. That's what we're asking.
All my friends are.
If you have a spare dime, send that dime to abrogate.org.
Take Bitcoin.
I'm sure Tim can figure out how to get us a Bitcoin wallet.
All right.
And I'm sure we would take them because. So far, like I said, most of the petitions are printing themselves. We're trying to save that up for advertising.
Okay, and your 180 days has started on September 1st.
September 1st.
So you got
quarter ounces.
There you go.
Yeah, we started September 1st, but like I said, that's a movable deadline. I'd like to stick with it because we came out to shoot run and there were lots of medical musical festivals and things, and we had the bridge walk. There's all kinds of stuff going on every weekend, and we have lots of signatures.
Nobody's keeping a running total.
Basically, we're telling everybody that's in a county coordinating kind of area to send us their numbers, and only two people have done that so far. So I know for sure we have like 200 or 300 signatures from what we've seen from the two and myself and him. And that's only from those. There's a guy in Warren that has them. He's got them up and down in Detroit at all the dispensaries. He's got them up and down the smoke shops in Warren. We got people in Kalamazoo. We got them all over the state. There's a group up in Otsonagan, and there's only 3,500 people in their entire town. He's like, or in their entire county. He's like, I think we have a great one of them. So, you know, I mean, it's just, we have up in the Noggin shop, up in the, we're all the way to the Houghton. Because we got the Noggin shop up there.
Who's an eligible signature?
You have to be a registered Michigan voter.
No, if you're not a registered voter.
Right, and so if you're helping us with signatures, you got to make sure they're registered. Make sure they know what town they live in. That's really sad. You have to kind of watch over a lot of them because they don't know what town they live in. They don't know what township they live in. Sometimes they don't know what county they live in. But they're registered to vote, and there's a way to go on your phone and see if the Secretary of State, if they are aware. And you have to make sure people watch that part where it says date. It says today's date, but people really think that means their birth date. So you got to watch them in blue or black ink only. So you got to pay attention to them. Make sure they know where they live and know how to write the day of the day that the day is. Oh no, honey, I have perfectly sober people. This one lady looked me right in the eye. I can't believe I have to give you my birthday, and I'm trying to tell her, no, 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 as she's writing, and I'm like, oh, we gotta cross you off.
Yeah, I always do the, and today's date is. And when you collect signatures for them, you can also collect for our candidates at the same time.
Yes.
And in fact, you probably more like even more people signing for us, because everybody wants to legalize pot. So you get them to first ask them to do that, and if they did that correctly, then ask them to sign your paper and
statewide. That is part of my plan as it gets farther in. I'm waiting for my own district until last, except for the people I've got collected for me in a few festivals. I figured I'm going to be going door to door, might as well take this with me.
Okay. Awesome. Yes. Donation of a second group. I'm not sure what that is.
Well, it was discussed last week.
The second meeting.
What?
The social meeting? Last month.
Okay, I wouldn't necessarily call that a second group, more of this group doing other things.
Yeah, that was very. I thought this was a splinter organization.
Yeah.
We are not
social guests.
Not social as garbage.
Okay.
So,
can I bring that out now?
Chair is right here.
That's fine.
We'll put this on the agenda.
Another pop.
We haven't really had a vote.
Yep.
There's no chair. It's
socialist. No hierarchy.
So don't worry. Just give me the chair.
Anybody have any thoughts or ideas? I have just want to just make it, if these are going to be second Wednesday, make a social meeting every fourth Saturday, so A, it's on the weekend, and B, you see each other a little bit more, you know, spread out. For people who don't want to read agendas or last month's minutes or
so basically
listen
like
to
a
me.
Bonfire type of thing.
Yeah, go to the bar, do a bonfire, whatever place you bought after.
I can do that.
Oh,
always be
here, I'm told.
Yeah.
It's just some way where we go business and stuff.
Yeah.
That way we're going to get more business done instead of more social life.
Well, yes.
Well, I second the motion.
Right. Well, no motion. Yeah, well, I would like to just make a motion. Let's just almost the
I second.
Hold on.
Has anything ever happened at your business meetings at Carl's house? Because I never go.
No, we just drank a couple of Carl's beers.
That he told me.
This doesn't really work this month. That's only a week and a half away.
It's a long drive now, but it's like, I didn't
really know. So last Saturday of every month?
Yeah.
All right, well, I just want to make my initial motion be motion to have our first purely social meeting on September 30th at Mannigan's Irish Hut in Mount Clemens, Michigan.
I second.
Following Friday. How is the following?
Mike, second.
Just to get the ball rolling.
I second.
Second, and we can pick different places every month.
So this is gonna be true.
So
we're all gonna get drunk? No!
I just really like that bar.
Yeah, drive from Mount Clemens to Great Town.
Mr. Mannigan will give us drinks.
Put that in the FB.
Hey.
Yeah.
Okay. Stop.
Okay, well, all in favor of the first meeting being at Mannigan's Irish Hut on September 30th?
All right,
we're just going to do it.
So,
Mike, we're doing it regardless.
So, now that it's been voted in, the state calendar, you want it in there?
The what?
State calendar, you want it in there, right?
Oh, yeah. Oh yes, please.
So, well, but since you're going to be changing locations each month, you'll have to give me a clue.
Yeah, I think it'll be more fun if we change locations.
If you give me a clue ahead of time, I'll make sure to keep updating that, because every other meeting for every other thing is consistently in the same place.
Yeah.
All right,
cool.
So
at least
the
website says
they are. I don't think they actually are. Well, first we do have, what was it? The strip club.
Wait, what now?
I can't remember the name.
I
I haven't seen the episode.
That's
a
that
week.
We just type in the name and
watch it.
Because
I only use that for like
trying to use
websites.
Are you
ready?
I'm running.
All right.
I need to get my petitions though. Have you started? Have you started? No, I need to get that.
Yeah, I haven't started.
Well, I can't find out how to put them online or some shit.
Then I'll send you.
I have, this is the leftover, but
I thought he was over to the county clerk, and the county clerk's like, no, we don't give them out for
no, we don't give them out anymore.
Yeah. They gave them to Jeff for government.
Thank you.
But they wouldn't give me mine. Nick, what the hell?
They fucking know you.
They know Jeff, too.
But probably because you have to have so many for governor, so.
You have to have the same fight.
What are you doing? That's
not it.
Oh.
James, question. Does Kid Rock know you're running against him?
He will.
And the MTV Video Music Awards is showing Kid Rock.
People said how they're going to top that, but I did rock.
So I guess this does kind of tie into my campaign, and also was an idea to help out Alicia because I'm going to be doing a campaign event at a pizza parlor, like pizza buffet place, and we were thinking about donating some of the proceeds.
Oh, okay.
Help out with your guys' court costs and everything else going on.
Nice. Thank you.
I will be getting some more information. I'll keep in touch with you guys via Facebook and stuff. And it's essentially going to be like a ticket-style program, like where we, you know, pass out tickets. The guy's going to be charging us roughly $5 a person for the food and everything else, so we can charge as much as we'd like for the tickets. I'm going to probably cap it at like 20.
Okay.
And then we'll take the profits and do a split, and that'll help you guys out, help out my campaign, and get the word out there. The place has seating for up to 100 people, so.
When is your court date?
I just got to move to October 17th. So
October 17th, okay.
Because the prosecutor is not at all interested in touching this at all. But the city administration just told him I don't know circumstances here.
How much was Nicholas Somber's rate?
When we talked to him, from what I talked to him, it was supposed to be a one and done situation because the prosecutor told me he was dismissing it when we were in court, so he said just we'll hear that one day was $1,000. But now it's continuing into a pretrial and then a regular trial. So, well, we'll see. Because I think the prosecutor might like before I do that.
Maybe.
All right.
John, what was the event?
We don't have a specific date yet. I'm gonna talk to him and try to get something solidified, but knowing that it's October 17th, we'll try to do something probably the second week end of October. That's what I'm going to go ahead and assume, like a Saturday or Sunday.
Do you think the owner was able to advocate petition meeting?
Oh,
you can do one.
Anything we want to do while we're there.
That's why.
He owns me.
There you go. He does what I tell him to.
Yeah, pretty much.
Anybody else?
No, he literally still owes me like $20,000. So, yeah.
You
do.
Okay.
Does anybody else have any other suggestions for outreach opportunities? Jim?
Particularly if you're going to do petition collecting. This time of year is a great time of year. Go downtown before the Tigers game. People are sitting down there waiting to get in. It's a great place to collect signatures. If you want to go get fucking drunk while you collect signatures, go down to Ann Arbor or Lansing before a football game. And those guys will sign your petition, and most of them will give you free beer. And that's always a good time.
I'm going to go to Ann Arbor.
Yeah, I mean, Ann Arbor, you might get what you're looking for, too.
I always
like that.
The other outreach thing that I'm going to be doing, I'm going to be signing up for the Trump or Treat again.
Trump or Treat?
So if anybody wants to volunteer for that, it's usually, I think, the weekend before Halloween. It's a parking garage in Mount Clemens, and we set up our trunk and we decorate it however we want. Last year it was Count Dracula and Gary Johnson on my trunk. And we just hand out candies for like a daytime safe trick-or-treating. So if anybody wants to volunteer, what's that?
We put razors in it?
Oh, no, they said raisins.
No, you're just being a prick.
I could dress up as Kevin Smith, the movie director, for example.
Yeah,
he has
to
do
that.
Yeah, because, I mean, nothing makes sense like giving away $100,000
of drugs. Well, it's a conspiracy. It does it all the time.
Obviously, we'll have an October meeting. Sign up before that. Basically, me and Matt Orlando did last year, except for Matt Orlando never showed up, so they ran out of candy. So we basically need like, if we want to be there all day, we need like 20,000 pieces of candy. But it's cool. So I'll just be the whoever wants to volunteer. You can just let me know. Just be my card.
So we give them a.
We give them candy. Yeah, exactly.
Who's gonna bring
it around? Most of them are adults, let's be honest. But I just had like last year, I had my campaign signs, and I was wearing my campaign T-shirt, and I had Gary Johnson signs, and I had
really,
I was an active member of this party and campaigned for one of this party's candidates. Alright, we'll move on to the membership director report.
We have to get the kids candy and then take 30% of it.
Yes, that's exactly what I was thinking.
We'll just have one guy dress as Uncle Sam at the very end.
I have a great way. You know, I have a great way of reaching out to people. A great way to do it would be you have like a table and the kids come up and they expect you and you expect them to fill out forms just to get candy like you're at the welfare office.
The children are going to have nightmares.
We politically radicalized my childhood dreams.
In order to collect candy, they have to first pay a license fee of 5 pieces of candy.
And you're 110 hours.
You make a you get a little too much candy, you get less candy from us.
Okay.
just like Bernie Sanders, who makes the most of their campaign.
But he makes sure everyone gets raisins.
He has three personal bags of candy.
It's not raisins, it's candy corn.
It's candy corn.
It's something
new. The market has decided it's candy corn. It's been around.
Oh.
Have you heard the Jordan Park?
To go.
Give me 1 second, so I think we should go over. 1 second. Let me get my pen out.
Okay. But no, I like candy corn. Me too. I can do a
little, but then it gets old after.
I like that.
But hey, sugar is a substance, so there should be like a DUI for.
The sugarizer. Instead of the breathalyzer.
What can I get for you, sir?
Chocolate mousse to go.
Anything else?
Now, you want that coffee? You can trip this to go.
What's that?
You can just box these up.
Do you want the coffee still?
Yes, please.
All right, membership director report. That's me. We need more members.
We have some more members today.
Oh, that's it. We have some new members.
Oh, good.
We don't have pretty sure they're not.
They live in McComb County. Just don't do it.
Pretty sure.
You just thought.
Oh, you need a form.
Give me a form.
Give him a form.
And a pen.
I'm going to verify that that's
on the table.
Thank you, man.
They signed the pledge, so you think they're worth it.
Nope. I'll bring your
paper.
This
new guy.
This
new guy.
Thank you. Yeah. So give him a pen. He didn't get a pen. He needs a form.
I keep getting him a form.
I need a form and a pen.
I've got a pen.
Why not? I'm halfway there.
I could have walked over there and sat.
If I knew they were over there, I would have got up and got
there. You go. Fill out the form. Okay. So we got three new members, two dues paying members, one of the. He's a human.
Alright.
So,
you don't
have
to pay.
Alright.
And you already paid.
I paid.
I added a membership form to the website, complete with the PayPal button. But as soon as we, the form's already on there and it's pretty old. I already tested it with Ben and I, so.
We have to do the test on the PayPal.
Yes, I'm waiting confirmation from the credit union to verify the PayPal account, but as soon as that's off, I'll post it to LMC chat and put something on the Facebook page. Awesome.
And where we can get off in the moment.
Also, I did start
and
store on Zazzle, so as soon as I get
PayPal,
it should be
pretty good. And then Zazzle has that shirt, right? No,
yes.
I got the shirt for that.
That's from Mike's store, should be starting.
You can just, you can take over my store.
I added a few new press releases and my tank materials blog.
Like Haggerty and 14 or 15 or something.
Yeah. I don't know what they do, or, but I see their sign all the time.
Maybe it's a Nazi group. I do know the
word. I know for a fact that they might be.
Right.
Target would probably be the beginning of November or something like that.
Alright. Did we get in touch with them here soon? They'd probably like to. No?
I haven't yet. That's safe.
Paul Connolly is still open because he's one late.
Right. Do you have a contact from
over here? I do actually, from convention, so yeah.
I tested Trello as an organizational tool, but I really think maybe something with video conferencing would be better for us. I've heard of Slack, but I haven't used it.
Slack's
also, GoToMeeting is a
Can you post the website address for that video conference thing on the page? Can you post the website, like the URL for that page? Yeah. I'd like to look at it.
Host. Gotcha.
I've heard of my setup on the cost of life. But I think Zoom is
our email account.
Right. Definitely.
Alright, treasury reports.
Okay. Like 57 from silver. You gave the donation. Three new members today. And I'll pass it on his there's a sheet here when I get his name. Because I keep track of the who's and John, do you have the money for that mailing? I can send a check. Right out the check.
Oh, we didn't need to do that because that were passed. So we didn't wind up doing that. We wound up being passed on all that. And the database was missing a ton of stuff, which I've actually gotten all figured out now. Thank God. Yeah, we didn't lose the database like we thought. Somebody went in there and screwed the stuff. I was able to back it up and get us back to where we were. Now, that is actually probably helping me with the
thank you.
Membership, getting everything back up to order on all that. Yeah, so sorry, go ahead, Dave.
Well, that's it. That's it as far as the treasury report goes.
Okay, well, I did introduce a resolution that's been emailed to you guys about Dana's petition, her initiative, and you guys can look through it. I would like to put a vote to that as soon as possible. And also, to speed things up here, I was talking to Catherine. We're going to get a newsletter thing together, but it could be more along the lines of a blog or something. We haven't really decided one way or the other yet, but so we're going to set a date, and it's going to be probably one of those groups that you were talking about, Mike. So yeah, we're gonna come up with a newsletter committee, maybe, or some group. Doesn't have to be a committee. It can be like, say, three people, and that's about it on that one. And I've been trying to talk Chrissy Wickers, who used to be Chrissy Jones, and are coming to this group. It won't be for at least another few months because she's living in Ohio right now. She used to live here in Michigan. I like her. I think she's fantastic, and she knows the ins and outs of y'all. So I think that would be very good for our benefit, and just to learn, get a learning experience and talk to her about this. And that's it coming from me.
Todd, did I hear you make a motion to adopt that resolution or just to review?
Yes, a motion if we could adopt it. Otherwise, we can review it one way or the other.
I can pull it up.
What was sent out, what you sent out to everybody, I used the same emails.
Yeah.
I don't know if everybody got them, but who didn't get them, somebody can share.
Here's Todd's resolution. Legalizing or decriminalizing marijuana in everyday Michigan. One, whereas the ballot initiative crafted by Dana Carver and the Treasurer Timothy Locke to either legalize or decriminalize marijuana and to abrogate the war on marijuana is the most libertarian referendum offered on the ballot for November 2018. Two, whereas the Let's Regulate Marijuana Like Alcohol initiative is not even remotely libertarian and will create tax and regulatory bodies.
Please.
Will not have the
thank you.
I ran out of seconds.
Oh, go ahead.
And choosing to grow marijuana legally, thus creating tax and regulated environment for the people who use marijuana recreationally and medically through the state of Michigan. Three, whereas the language of Abrogate Michigan's ballot initiative is the most libertarian that is on the ballot. Four, whereas the most sensible option for Michigan standards who want marijuana without any criminal or legal penalties aimed at them. Be it resolved that the libertarians in Macomb County will support the petition put out by Dana Carver and Timothy Locke via their Abrogate Michigan and bring an end to the war on marijuana via legalization and decriminalization of the substance as the first step to the end of the abominable war on drugs, which will restore Michigan's full constitutional government.
Is that Trevor's name right? Is that Trevor's name correct?
Thank you very much.
Can we take a vote?
Does
anybody have anything to add, subtract?
Call the question.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Sounds like a set.
Anybody
else?
Division.
Thanks,
Keith. Thank you, guys.
And this is my report. One thing I just want to comment on is
we passed it.
It's always going to be a lot higher going into election or just coming off of an election, but so far this is the highest attended meeting we've had at this location, including several new members. Now that we have the social meetings, at least one social meeting on the schedule, I want to encourage everybody to at least bring a friend. I don't even care if they have a tattoo of marks on their chest. Just bring any one friend, just to And the other thing I just want to report on is, it turns out Kickstarter is a real pain in the ass to use, but GoFundMe is real easy. So all we need is the EIN, and we'll be able to start collecting funds for the statue, even though statues aren't very popular right now. I just need a copy of the EIN. We can start collecting money online. And also, I never actually spent a lot of time on GoFundMe other than like my own friends' personal stuff. But I feel like our statue's pretty new in comparison to these other crowds.
Motion to adjourn.
Our single bank account is going to be used for the next month.
If that is under an EIN.
You had to have an EIN.
In order to call ourselves nonprofit, which I feel like,
we don't.
I could just set it up for Mike is going to build a statue and do it right now, but if we just put it with the EIN, I feel like, if we already have an EIN, it's easier. If we don't, I would totally disagree.
Dave, is your concern in the interview?
No, I don't remember.
You
need to
be addressing
stuff for the statue.
Mike,
the Tiananmen Square version of the delivery.
I move for that. No.
We'll be able to have the report from the GoFundMe to see exactly how much money is affected to go to GoFundMe. So we'll have a dollar figure that was
specifically meant for it. It goes into it. It doesn't go into
my account. No, it won't go into that account if I don't put it to that account. I have like three empty accounts that we're trying to use that are.
You can have it etched in bronze on the base.
Alright, motion to adjourn.
Second.
Okay, well then I just need the EIN. I don't need any accounts.
John just made the motion and seconded it.
He made the motion.
But I think he has something to say.
I have one more piece of new business. Our PO box that I got for 6 months is up for renewal at the end of September. And I'd like to propose a motion to renew that. It's $27 at third location for a 6 month service for the smallest box of the cheapest post office we've got.
Second.
For fundraising letters and membership outreach to old members.
Murder new mass emails, we need a PO box.
All right, all those in favor of extending the P.O. box for another 6 months at $27 from the Treasury, yes.
Aye.
Aye.
Vote in favor.
I also have a vote for the P.O. from the last one. Okay.
So you want me to write to the Treasury? Sure. I have one
of the open
floor. Yes.
All right, so most of you here know me. I'm moving to Macomb County at the end of this month.
Really?
The first two Fridays of the month, I'm going to be having a big bonfire at my new farmhouse in Armada.
Oh, I didn't see that.
So,
awesome.
Come out and bring some firewood, and it's a long fucking way away. So if you want to put up a tent, you're welcome to. Or
how close are your neighbors? A
lot closer. Yeah. I can still see it.
What's that noise of the actual?
That's about it.
All road is where all the stuff
awesome.
Yeah.
Gaylord is where
I will be there for at least one of them, Jim. At least one.
What were the dates?
If you want to stick around and help me unpack, that'd be cool.
We'll see what
Friday the 13th and whatever the Friday before that is.
In October.
Yeah. 7 days in
New Those are
the right,
four.
Six.
6 days.
Those are the two Fridays when my wife is out of town. So.
Good time to make right. money in Florida. I'm in Florida. Enjoying a beast that just got rained out.
Yeah, there's
somebody
just there.
That's my time share. I'm pretty much stuck there. Are we about
you got a timeshare?
I'm sure it's like the stupidest thing ever.
They don't pay.
Move my move
a
all
check.
Rubbish.
And you're going to stick
your money in my pocket. Just so you
sounds
know.
Like it came out all right.
That would be
the facility
itself.
I have all here.
Thanks.
See what it has on it? That's my home address.
Okay.